Welcome back, everyone. Today, we're going to look at the course goals and expectations. The course goal of this class is for you to learn visual and computation techniques, and importantly, how to use them in a complementary way. So that means, how do you take advantage of the visual aspect and also the computation, the scalability aspect? And also, we want you to learn a breadth of knowledge, so we cover a lot of things. And more importantly, how you will use them all in practical ways, so solving real problems and using real data. And this course schedule is roughly based on what I call the analytics building block, so I have a lot more information about this shortly. And this course schedule, you can think of it as divided into multiple parts. The first part in green is data collection, data cleaning, integration, and then the blue part, analytics and visualization. And then finally, presentation and dissemination. So notice that these are pretty rough division, so that's not meant to be very rigid. And also I'd like to mention that these are what I call the building blocks. So they are not rigid steps. It doesn't mean that when you have a problem, a data set you want to analyze, you must go through data collection, must go through data cleaning or integration. Actually, some of these building blocks you can skip. So I don't want to call them steps, because steps usually cannot really skip or go back. But here are building blocks, so you can skip some. You can even go back. So you can think of these building blocks as two-way streets. For example, you can imagine that after you collect the data, looking at the data type, they may say, so with this type of data, let's say time series, or this is graph data, then I may want to design my visualization, so one of the blue blocks there, in a different ways. So similarly, having collected the data, you may start to think about, I want to use a particular graph algorithm or an algorithm of time series. So that's another blue block, analytics. Or similarly, you can go way back, for example, from visualization, starting with a blue block. And then after looking at the data, you may see that, the data is actually pretty dirty. Maybe I need to do some data cleaning. So that means you go back to the green part. And similarly, visualization may also inform algorithm design. For example, you may look at the result and then say, this doesn't really make sense, the result. So maybe I am using a wrong or maybe not a very good algorithm. So building blocks, but not rigid steps. So a lot of students would like to ask me in the beginning of the course is, are you ready to take this class? So often what I would say is that you'll be ready if you are willing to do a lot of programming and willing to learn a lot of new things in a very short amount of time. So for example, in this class, you will not only learn about how to work with large data using Hadoop and Spark, but also look at how to do visualization, let's say using JavaScript, web-based technology, CSS, and so on. So a lot of times it can be overwhelming, especially if you don't know a lot of the techniques. But it's actually very, very important and very common in industry that you will need to learn a lot of things in a short amount of time. So I would consider this class actually a very good practice to get used to the very quick pace of learning things. From previous classes, a lot of the projects in this class turn into publications at top-tier venues. Let's say KDD, a top data mining conference, or IUI, a top human-computer interaction conference. And also, a lot of students use their projects as the portfolio pieces on their CV. So this is actually really attractive for employers to see how a student, what a student has done in the course, not only about things that they've learned, but also actually real problems they've solved. So the project in this course allow them to include those experiences as part of their CV. And of course, because of that, then have increased job and internship opportunities. And I'm really excited to often hear from students that they would send me a thank you note to say, so I learned a lot of these skills, and partly because of that, I got this job. Of course, I cannot take all the full credit, but I think it's nothing more heartwarming than hearing that from the students. So here are some example projects from previous classes. So Origo is a project for finding interesting paths to look at or to visit or tourist attraction to look at in a new cities that you want to visit. And another project would be about the placement of fire station. So how do you place fire station closest to the fire incident so that you can cut down the commute time? Another project is how to find safe path going from point A to point B. So it's very interesting because it's not only about looking at how do you go from those two points are very quickly, but instead, how to go there in a safe way. Here are some of the texts that I receive from former students. So we say that your class is really helpful because they help you gain these number of skills. And then also because of that, they got a job offer. So again, I cannot take full credit for it, but it's really, really helpful for me to know that they learn about these skills. And in their job, they also make use of them. So I gave a very quick overview about the course goal and expectations. And also, I use the analytics building block to motivate why we want to learn all of these, and also show you a few example projects that come from this class. So I hope we'll see a lot more example projects like this from you. Thank you.